Hi everyone, welcome to the 12th standard English class. I'm Jasmine and this is the 15th module. In this module, we are going to discuss the new words and phrases from the chapter An Elementary School Classroom in a Slum, written by Stephen Spender, taken from the book Flamingo. As we already discussed in the previous modules, the poem An Elementary School Classroom in a Slum by Stephen Spender deals with the marginalized section of our society. Through this poem, the poet reveals the ugly truth that when half of the population is enjoying the riches of the world, the other half is struggling to lead a decent life. Now let's see the new words and phrases that the poet uses in the poem, which gives deeper meaning and impact to it. The first one is gusty waves, which means a strong wind or breeze. But here in the poem, it refers to a good environment with fresh air and open space. Here the poet tells the slum children are far away from such an environment. The next one, rootless weeds. Weed is a wild plant growing where it is not wanted. Here, the poet is bringing a comparison between weeds and the people of the slum. Just like weeds, the people in the slum is unwanted by the society. They are also mentioned as rootless weeds because they lack a good ancestry or legacy. The next one is hair tone round their pallor. Pallor means an unhealthy, pale appearance. The children in the slum look weak and pale due to malnutrition. Next one, weighed down head. The tall girl in the poem is described as her head weighed down, which means the girl is ill and exhausted. Maybe the poet is trying to say that the girl is fed up with her life in the slum. The next one, stunted, unlucky hair of twisted bones. Usually, people inherit property or other valuable things from their ancestors. But here, the unlucky boy, he's inheriting not property but twisted bones, a disease from his parents. Next one, civilized dome riding all cities, which means the beautiful architecture such as tall building and other structures which is present in the city. The next one, belt flowery Tarlis Valley. The Tarlis Valley is a beautiful valley which is colorful, full of flowers, rivers, mountains and the chirping birds. It signifies civilization, which the children in the elementary school will never be part of. It is a contrast to the condition of the classroom, as it is a place of beauty. The next one, a narrow street sealed in with the lead sky. It means that the children live in a congested, narrow street. They are trapped there and have nowhere else to go. The lead sky means pollution and the burden of the industrial world. The next one, far, far from rivers, capes and stars of woods. Through this line, the poet refers that the slum children are far away from the beautiful geographies such as rivers, mountains and even from the stars of woods, which means from getting good education. The next one is slag heap, which means heaps of waste which is discarded by the people of the city. But here in this line, it refers to the slum children. The next one is skins peeped through by bones, which means the poor slum children are subjected to a life of misery and hopelessness and extreme poverty. The poet uses this particular phrase to indicate the malnourished bodies of the slum children. Next one, blot their maps with slums as big as doom. Through this line, the poet tells the slum children to proclaim the world their existence by blotting the map, which only shows a rich world. The next one is catacombs, which means an underground cemetery. Just like dead bodies in an underground cemetery, they live an undignified life inside the dark slums. And the final word is azure, which means bright blue, just like a cloudless sky. Here, the poet requests the authorities to do something for the slum children so that they can break the slums and come out to the open spaces and breathe fresh air under the wide, bright blue sky. So these were the new words from the poem. I hope the session was helpful. Thank you.